واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم الصادق الوعد الامين وعلى اله واصحابه الذين قال لهم الناس ان الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم ايمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. My brothers and sisters in Islam, I apologize to come late because I promised I will be here for iftar. But wallahi, today I forgot two things. Insan daif. I supposed to be at Abu Huraira. 11 masajid were there at 6 o'clock. I forgot. And this one too, I supposed to be here for iftar and I forgot. And my brother reminded me. We need that at the Ethiopian Community Center. I said, must be today, after iftar. Then I ran, I came here. I apologize. Ma'adirat and wakulul ma'adirat. As we know, today we cannot pass by today without remembering the 17th day of Ramadan when Quwwatul Haqq التقت قوه الحق بقوه الباطل. يوم بدر was today, and what I would like, سبحان ربي العظيم, I don't know where to start. I am very happy to see this gathering, and I was away for about a year. I was in Egypt, but I was following the events as it unfolds back home. Sheikh Jamal was talking, can I ask you everyone to stand up? 1 second, please. Stretch. Okay, sit down. Because to talk, you have to have the audience. When the audience is tired, there's no point to talk at them. I hope you're okay now, inshallah ta'ala. Yes, we are talking that what is going on, how the Muslims saw that Allah should be, may help us, that's good. But I'll start with giving a glad tidings for you. Number one, if you didn't hear, in December of last year, the Pope Benedict made a speech. We were watching in Egypt. He said, you know, the Christian is in number are higher than Muslims, but that's not the case yet. He said, Islam has surpassed Christianity by $3 million people. Why that? He was asking question. He replied himself. He said, the reason is because too much, you know, publicity is too much talking about Islam. I don't go into what he said. He said they should ease up. Because the people, by nature, he said, curious. They want to know what the people, the media is talking about. So the increasing number is because he mentioned by, because of the Christian and Jewish people are hugging Islam. So Allah's religion is in perfect shape. You don't have to worry about that, about Islam. That's the glad tidings for you. We worry about ourselves. We should worry about ourselves. Islam, all the religions, when Allah revealed to his prophets, he told the messenger and those people, they must vidu alayhi, because Allah did to them to guard that religion. Only Islam. Islam, Allah took upon himself guarantee to protect. But we have to ask Allah Ta'ala to give us knowledge and guidance, because by knowledge, especially at a time of like this and what's going on in our land back home, only knowledge saves. I'll take you back quickly to Pharaoh's time, when Pharaoh taught his people. Because I have only 10 minutes, that's why I'm going in only in English. I want to say as much time as I can for myself. When he told them, I'm going to cut you your legs, your hands, and I will hang you up. Those who have knowledge say to him, فَقْدِ مَا أَنْتَ غَابٍ إِنَّمَا تَقْضِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Judge whatever, do whatever you want to do, rule whatever you know, this judgment is only for this dunya. Take it back there now. That is why I say that. Those who are jailed, who are tortured, was this. Those who have knowledge, a real knowledge. Knowledge of Aqidah, knowledge of the Tawheed, they don't waver, they say, do whatever you want to do. Because this is the dunya. Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah quickly, Qatar, arrested him. They gave him three ultimatums, three choices. Either to be exiled from the country or to be jailed, lifetime imprisonment, or to be executed. He replied, I don't know which one to choose from, because all three of them are the best. If you jail me, imprison me, life imprisonment, I will be in seclusion with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. That is the best. If you exile me, you exile me to a new place, I will carry out a da'wah there, that is the best. If you excuse me, I am shaheed, conveying Allah said, that is the best. Whichever you do is the best, I don't know which one to choose. He replied, he is crazy, let him free. That's how they let him, Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. So, just, you have the best weapon. We have the best weapon. That is resorting to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in this month, sincerely, and following Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the fullest extent, then, وَالْعَقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. May Allah make all of us pious, because the goal for this month is piety. Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, rather, Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, if I have known that one of my good deeds is accepted by Allah, I would be very, very happy, he said. Why? They asked him. He said, Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Then I know I am one of the pious. If he accepts one. So we have to strive as much as we can to ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, to worship Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala according to how the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam advised us. So, in this month of Ramadan, and we must resort to Allah, that is the best thing. Seek Allah's help for those people who are being tortured, imprisoned, and you name it. That Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala gives victory. Allah guaranteed He is going to give victory to those who are pious. So, as I started, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, His religion, this religion He took upon Himself, guaranteed to protect. When Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala sent all the messengers, He sent with two things. One is a message, and to support that message, He gave them a miracle. Because if your neighbor gets up and comes to you, I am a messenger, you're not going to believe. Are you sure? You're going to ask him, you're going to question, but Allah gave them a miracle. But those two things, every messenger except Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the message, that is the book, and a miracle separate. In the case of Isa, Musa came, in the case of Isa, curing the sick people, you know, and reviving the dead people, you name, in the case of Salih and Sinaqa, she came in. So separate, miracle and the message. But with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, both came in one thing, that is the Quran. It's a message, the Quran is a miracle. That is why Quran cannot be understood in any language except other than Arabic. If we understand from it in another language, only the message, not the miracle. Only in Arabic. I'll give you an example, one quick example. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, the basic one. In Arabic, in English language, praise be to Allah. I don't know in your language, I wish I know, because Allamahul Bayan, the language is Allah's ayah, Allah's sign. He is the one who made no different kind of language. That's what I mean, okay? Underline. So, we say, Galani Harabiti. At the same time, he praised him. He praised Muhammad, he praised Musa, you can say. But in Arabic language, it is impossible to say Alhamdulillah is Zaydin. No way. Only to Allah, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, cannot be translated. To give you just one little example. You go in Surah Al-Muddathir, وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ رَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. For those of you who know Quran, if you read from that side to this way, it's رَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ too. رَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ رَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. You can read from both sides. You cannot do it in any language. So you get only the meaning, not the miracle out of it. Why did I say that? The reason why I say that, seek knowledge. I just came from a place that is Egypt, where French, Russian, Chinese, Americans, you name another whole Dutch people, they all young, they are there to seek knowledge. How can I practice the religion I don't understand? This is their slogan.